Hello dear student, I welcome you all in this video of revision. As you know that we have started with the revision, and today we'll discuss with the revision grammar chapter number 2, that is adverbs, and in that we have degree, frequency, negation and interrogative. First of all, we will try to understand the concept of this all four types. Then we'll look for a question. Remember, it is just the revision, not the teaching. So I'm just going to revise it in short to make you more clear about the ideas which we have. So let's see. Just before we begin with this, when I ask you the question that what is adverb? So adverb is a word that describes verb, a particular action, that how it has happened. We already discussed about this, correct? So when the action is happening, so how it is happening, that is described by the word adverb, and such a words we call them as adverb only. So let's see, we have different types of adverb here, like degree we have first, the second frequency, time, negation and interrogative. So very first we have degree. What is adverb degree? If you ask a question, so adverb degree is, it is giving you the example to you to what extent the particular action has happened, to what level, to what amount the particular action has happened. Example is given there that these shoes are too big for you. So the shoes are big, yeah it is, but how much they are big, to what extent they are too big, getting it, they are too big. So more than the particular feet, the shoes are more big, too big. So it's giving you the level of it, how much it is. You know, I'm extremely happy. I'm happy, but how much I'm happy? Extremely I'm happy. So that is showing in the level of the particular action, how much level, to what extent is happening. For that purpose, we use this adverb degree. Let's go for next is frequency. Frequency tells you how often, okay, it tells you how often that particular action has happened, how many times it has happened, how many times, this is more important, you can count it, one and two and three or few times, sometime, this kind of words are used in this. So remember the word how often and how many times it has happened, this is a very important point. So you can see the example, Vinod always comes late to school, so he is always late, not one or not twice, he is always. So many times the action is happening. How often? It's often, not often, it's often. So how many times the particular action is happening, that is exactly brief here. And when you can count the action, how many times it's happened and how often it has happened, for that purpose we use adverb frequency. Next we have adverb time. It's very simple. It is simply giving the answer when. If you ask a question that when a particular action has happened, you will get the answer of time only. So look at the question here. I read the story today. So I have read the story. But when? If I ask the question, when you read the story? Today we have read it. I went before. So before, it's showing you the time. Today, yesterday, day first, day before, after. So this all are the words that shows you the particular time of the action. Okay. The next we have negation. It's also very simple. When you find the word not, never, didn't, doesn't, like these words are used negative, they show a negative remark of the particular sentence, we call them as adverb negation. Example is given here, John is not feeling well. So not describing you that he is not feeling well. Okay, so the not is used, hence it is example of adverb negation. The next we have interrogative adverb. It is again more simple to identify. Interrogative adverb tells you it's about a question only. Like whenever you find a question, definitely it is adverb interrogation, or we can say the interrogative adverb. But remember, don't confuse yourself in interrogative adverb and interrogative adjective. Okay, when you talk about interrogative adverb, you will find the word did after the WH word. It means what? You will find the verb here. In adverbs, you will find the verb here after WH question. But in interrogative adjective, you will find noun here after the WH word. Noun you will find. Example like what gift. So what gift if I say, so gift is noun here, example of adverb, adjective. And if I ask like what is, so is verb here, example of interrogative adverb. Are you got that? So this is the important point to understand here. Just revise in short time. Degree tells you that how much level, to what extent the action has happened. Frequency tells you that how many times, how often the action has happened. Time tells you that when action has happened. Negation tells you that about negation, that not, never, these words are used. And interrogative tells you that it's a question. So these are the short techniques to identify a particular adverb. Practice it well this much and then you can go for the examples. So let's see now the examples, how can we get to it clearly. Okay, let's go for the examples. So when we find some of the example at that time, definitely we'll come to know that, and it will be easy for you as well to identify the particular adverbs. Okay, so we have first question, how many books have you read this month? So the question is, how many books have you read? So already I have underlined the verbs here to just make you understand that is a verb only or adverb only, sorry. So this is adverb and we need to describe it, we need to identify it, which type of adverb it is. Now hence it is a question, can you guess which kind of adverb it is? Yeah, correct, very good. So it is adverb of interrogative, interrogation, because it's a question. When it is a question, definitely it's kind of interrogative only. So it is interrogative adverb first. How is the adverb? And it is interrogative adverb. Next we have, he is never sad. Okay, the never word is used, never sad. So never means what we can say here? It is a negation, negative remark is given there. So he is never sad. Never is negative word and for that purpose it is the example of adverb negation. Next, number third example we have, I have done this before. Okay, just you have discussed now that before is the word that shows you time. When have you done this? When you ask a question, you will give the answer before. So before is an example of, before is an example of time. It's adverb of time. Number fourth we have, they often go to the library. Now they often go to library. If I ask you a question, how many times they go? They go often. Often, many times they go. So it's counting a particular action. Many times we are doing it. So it is adverb of frequency, often. Adverb of frequency it is. Next, number fifth one we have, the sun had nearly set. Okay, the sun has set, but it was nearly set, not completely set. So it is showing you how much level the particular action has happened. So it is nearly setting, not at set. So nearly is describing you the particular action. So it is the example of adverb of degree. It's showing you how much level amount is happening. So nearly it's adverb of degree only. Number six we have, we really enjoy the song. Really, we enjoy the song, but how much we enjoy? We really enjoy it. So it is also showing you the degree amount of particular action, how much has happened. We really enjoy it. So it is showing you that how much level the particular action has happened. Then number seventh question we have, number seventh example we have. So it is also adverb degree only. It is also adverb degree only. Number seventh, my father sometimes takes me to the market. So my father is taking to the market, but when? How much time? Sometime only he is taking, not always. So sometime is the example of adverb frequency again, because it's showing you how many times the action is happening. So it is frequency, adverb frequency. Number eight example we have, she went to Pune yesterday. So she went Pune, but when she went? She went yesterday. So yesterday is giving you the time. Okay, it's showing you the time of particular action, and hence this example of adverb time. Number ninth example we have music classes twice a week. So we have the classes, but how many times they have? Twice in a week. And when we ask how many times, and it is an example of adverb frequency. Very good. And number 10th example we have, that how tall is that building? Now when you ask that how tall is that building, it's again a question. And whenever you have a question, definitely it's an example of adverb interrogation. Or we can call it that interrogative adverb. Have you got that? So remember this key point, dear student, which I've given you in this previous slide. and try to remember all that, practice well, and solve many and more example so that it will be easy for you to get the out of marks in the examination. Okay, thank you and best luck.